Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, my name is Abby and I make videos on just about everything. Beauty, fashion, lifestyle, crafts. There's gonna be some plants in this video today. So I'd love it if you guys subscribe, stick around, follow me on Instagram. Or check out some more of my videos. That would be great. So let's get started. Today I'm going to be doing a current favorites, kind of like a summer favorites, kind of just like what I'm liking right now. It's a bunch of random stuff, honestly. I have some fashion, some beauty, and then just totally random. So let's get started. The first thing that's just like in front of me is we're gonna do beauty, is the Aspen Ovard palette. And I got this at Ulta. I remember seeing it the first time and I was like, oh, this is really pretty and everything, but like, I don't need it. And then I went back again and I bought it. I'm trying not to blind you guys, but it's got really great colors, perfect for summer, and honestly, like, they're like my kind of colors that I use all year round. And they've got a blush and a highlighter in here. You don't necessarily need the highlighter in here, like, it's a really great highlighter, but a lot of the other shadows you could use as a highlighter if you wanted to. So like maybe a bronzer would have been better in here, but I guess bronzer gets kind of tricky with like different skin tones and stuff like that. The only thing about this is there is kind of a bit of fallout and it kind of falls out under your eyes, but I just sweep it away with my brush and you're good to go. So I'm wearing it today. Most of these products I am wearing today, just so you can get the full effect. Next product that I'm wearing today is the Hourglass Caution Extreme Lash Mascara. Now this I was sent for free for review, but I'm not getting paid or anything like that. This is amazing. Like, I don't know if you guys have realized, but I'm a pretty big, like, critic on my mascaras. Since I have hooded eyes, mascara tends to rub off on my eyelids, and just because it also kind of rubs off underneath my eyelids, but this does not. So a lot of times I try to do, like, waterproof, but then you run in with the hassle of it literally, like, never coming off. Like, you have to, like, scrub your entire eye to get your mascara off. But this one does not do any of that. I remember putting it on for the first time and I was like, oh shoot, I love this. And so it does not go anywhere, but it's also not so hard to get off. You can get it off with a makeup wipe, or like if you just kind of scrub your eyes a little bit when you're washing your face, it comes right off, but it doesn't smudge off throughout the day, which I love. So this mascara does like insane volume and length. I'm going to insert some clips here of my eyes before. I don't have the best eyelashes, but like they're fine. And then with just one eyelash done, and then now I have both of them done, I just think it like almost makes you look like you have false lashes on. It is amazing. I highly, highly, highly recommend this to everyone. Like I said, I was just sent to this. I don't have to do anything. But I was even telling the people at work about this. And when I start to tell my friends and like people outside of like YouTube and stuff like that is when I really consider a product great. $29, which is like a little bit more expensive for a mascara, but I definitely think it's worth it. I don't know why I'm using it as like a wand. Okay, to go along with mascara, this is kind of like totally random, but this is an eyelash separator that I got from Ulta. One time I was ordering online and I needed to spend a little bit more money to get free shipping. And I'll show you a close-up of this, but this is great because that mascara can tend to get a little bit clumpy if you're not careful. So this, you literally, okay, I hope I don't stab myself because I really can't see what I'm doing, but you literally just go like this and you kind of shimmy it a little bit and it like separates all your eyelashes really well. I used to do this with my tweezers and I do not recommend that because I would sometimes stab myself, but I really love this if you have a problem with your eyelashes getting clumpy or anything like this. Definitely, definitely recommend. Okay, so now on to skincare. The first thing is this Murad Environmental Shield Rapid Resurfacing Peel little towelette thingies. So I recently got a facial at Massage Envy, and the girl that I got the facial from, her name was also Abby, so, you know, we connected. but she was so helpful and she knew so much, and like I literally like was the annoying person that asked a million questions, but she was like oh my gosh, she just gave me so much information. And I, at the end, I was like, can you write down like every single thing you just told me? And like in my head, while she was giving me the facial, I was like, I should have her come on my YouTube channel. But then I was like, I'd be scared to ask. But so this is one of the things that I got. So while I was getting the facial, I got glycolic acid. It wasn't like a peel, but like, and it wasn't a mask. I don't really know. But I have really congested pores on my nose, and I was actually taking Retin-A from my dermatologist for it. And we kind of figured out a little bit of a different skincare routine that I can talk to you guys about if you'd like. But I, like, they're not clogged anymore, and it's amazing, because when I used to put on foundation, they would be so bumpy. My nose would just look like a freaking like anthill. And now it's like, it's so smooth. It's amazing. Like, I'm just so shocked by it. So these really, really help with that. And you just use it, it says 2 to 3 times a week on here, but she told me like 2 maybe. And then you just use your moisturizer after, and it is great. I really, really, really recommend this. So then the next skincare thing is not, I mean, I guess it's technically skincare, but it's the Lancome RegenaLift Ultra Action, Multi-Action Ultra. And it is a moisturizer that is firming and dark spot correcting, but it also has SPF 30 in it. Now, this I really like for in the mornings. I typically don't wash my face in the mornings, but I'm gonna start to. And so I like this kind of like as a primer because it has the SPF 30 in it, which is really great for summertime. So I really like this just as a light moisturizer and primer in the mornings. It is great. Okay, so then kind of my last, well, not last, I don't know, beauty thing is my nails. So I have been this summer getting the dip powder nails. And before like my freshman year of college, I got acrylic for the first time and I really liked it, but it was really, really hard on my nails. And I have really flimsy nails to begin with, so I was kind of like, nah, what more damage can I do, you know? But then I don't know, they were just a little too much for me. And so actually my mom first got the dip nails, and then I was like, okay, you get them, test them out, and then we'll see where we go from here. And she didn't like them because they were too thick for her nails. Because they are adding layers on top of your nails, it makes them thicker. But I love them so much. So basically, if you don't know what they are, they're kind of like a step above gel and a step below acrylic. They just paint this little like adhesive stuff on and then dip it in this little powder, and then they tap it off, and then they do it like 2 or 3 times. And this is what they look like. I'm a really bad picker. If part of my gel starts to come off, I will pick every single nail off. You leave these on and don't mess with your nails. They're actually really healthy. Well, they're not healthy for your nails, but they help your nails grow because they last so long. And a lot of times with gel, what happens is like the base, when it starts growing out, like you can kind of pick at it and then it comes up. But this does not happen at all. The only time I had a little bit, like right here, I can kind of feel it. So what I do is I just take a little nail file and kind of like file it down a little bit, and it helps so much. And I really like getting light colors just because that's, I like that. But also when it starts growing out, you don't notice it as much. So yes, I highly recommend dip. Okay, so now on to fashion. These have been like my summer staples. So these are just rainbow flip-flops. I got these from DSW because the job that I've had over the summer is like a clothing boutique store, and we stand on our feet literally the entire shift, which I just was not used to, standing literally for 9 hours and not sitting down except for like one like 30 minute break. So, and I also have pretty old lady feet that my feet mess with my hips, and it's just not a fun time. So I was getting like granny orthopedic shoes, which I can show you guys, like comfortable, cute shoes, because I actually found a lot. But I also got these, which are so comfortable. And I really like them because they're a step up from just a generic flip-flop. They are more expensive, but they last so, so long. I had a pair of rainbows from, like, my mom still has her pair when we got them together. I want to say it was like 10 years ago. Yeah, like 8 or 10 years ago. And she still has hers. I obviously outgrew mine. But I'm so glad that I got these again because you can wear them with literally anything. You can wear them with just jean shorts, or when I was in Florida, I wore them like over almost every night that we went out. I mean, we weren't like going to the clubs, but I don't know. I really love them, really recommend them. They have good arch support and are just really comfortable. So then, speaking of jean shorts, these shorts have been like my summer favorite. They are the Old Navy boyfriend shorts, and I wear a size 0. Coming back from school this past summer, I realized I had gained a little bit of weight, so none of my shorts fit me, which was awesome. And I needed new shorts, and I don't like booty shorts. I have long legs, and they just look like giraffe legs if I wear too short of shorts, and I'm not comfortable with that. So I definitely look for 3 to 3.5 inch shorts, and that's what these are. And they're really inexpensive, great quality. They've got a nice like stretch to them. They're not too tight since they are the boyfriend style. I have them in this color and then like a darker wash that is currently in the laundry. But I really recommend these if you guys are still, I know it's like the end of the summer, but it doesn't start to get cold in St. Louis or Indianapolis until like October. So I still got a couple more months. So yeah, I really, really love these. And then I have this hat. I've really been into these hats this summer, and I think they're so cute. They're called Panama hats, I believe. I could be wrong, but I'm pretty sure, like straw Panama hat. I had one that was from Forever 21 that I really, really liked. I still have it actually, but I took it on my trip to France with me in the beginning of the summer, and we went from like 8 different hotels, and so it just got smushed in my bags. And since it was from Forever 21, it wasn't that great of quality, so I knew that before I went to Florida I wanted a new one. And I kind of like searched everywhere for like the perfect hat because I didn't want to spend too much money. But the ones at Nordstrom, which are the pretty popular ones, I think they're like Brixton or something, were just way too flat for me. I did not want ones that were like super flat, and so I found one on Gap that I really liked, but then when I went to go buy it, they were sold out, so that was cool. But this one is from World Market, which I was like totally so surprised by, and I love it because it's got like a little bit of flimsiness to it, and but then it's not like a big old like floppy hat. And it was really cheap. It was under $30, and at the time it was on sale, and I did Ebates cash back, so I got money off technically. So I really like this. If you guys are in the search or on the hunt for one of these, I will leave it linked down below. Now I have wonderful hat hair. These sunglasses are my next favorite, and they are from ASOS. It's going to be a little hard to see because they are very reflective. Again, I got these right before I went to Florida, and I just think they're so cute. They were not very expensive. They've got like a pink outer rim and then just like a reflective, like almost greenish color lens. Just a fun pair of sunglasses for the summer. And then my last fashion favorite is these earrings from Target. I have been obsessed with these this summer. I have to be really careful with what earrings I wear because my ears are super sensitive and will get like all red and itchy and hurt if I wear like really cheap earrings for a long time. But these are really great. They're very, very lightweight, and they're just so cute and fun. And I wore them while I was in Florida. I've worn them many other times, and I really like them. Target has some really, really cute earrings right now. Okay, so now onto some kind of random stuff. This first one is this coffee. I was too lazy to go downstairs and get the actual carton, but this is, so I just have my glass that actually spilled out on the entire floor this morning, so that was really fun to clean up. But that is the Starbucks caramel macchiato, the one you can buy in the container, and I will insert a picture here. I have been obsessed with it this summer. I'm not normally a huge coffee person, but I am a person who gets tired very easily, and I'm honestly like always tired. Really been loving that this summer. It's way cheaper than buying it like at Starbucks each morning. I also really like Dunkin' Donuts coffee, but I haven't been able to find like a bigger container of their coffee that you can buy at the store. So let me know if you know of that. And then this one is random, and I don't want to say this is controversial, but it's definitely like a newer subject. This is CBD oil. Weed, marijuana, is made up of multiple things, but the main things are THC and CBD. So THC is the psychoactive part. That's what like alters your mind and your body and all that kind of stuff that like makes you high, basically. And then CBD is the like, not the effects of it. I don't really know how to explain it, but this helps a lot. I have pretty bad anxiety and I take prescription medicine every day for it, but this really helps if I'm having like an anxiety attack or a panic attack or something, or if I know that I'm going into a situation where I might, like, I don't really have anxiety flying, but I know that I possibly could, so I take this on trips a lot with me or whenever, and it is great. And this can be used for so many things. So my mom has sleeping problems and like almost insomnia, and she has been taking this for the past couple nights and has seen a huge difference. It helps my friend, her mom, she has shoulder pain, and I gave her some of this and she said that it helped a lot. My other friend, her mom, her daughter, my friend, has anxiety. She took it as well, and their grandma is actually going to start chemotherapy, unfortunately, and she, they're gonna get her some of this too because of the nausea. So I am not like trying to push this or anything, but I definitely say if you think that it could be helpful, definitely look into it. I was a little bit skeptical at first, but mine is 150 is like the strength, I guess, and you can take as much or as little as you want. Me, it doesn't have any physical like effect on me. I'm not, like, I don't notice it. So when I am having a panic attack and I take it, I'm not like, whoa, like, I'm chill. I just, like, the panic attack just, like, goes away. So I don't know what happens with the higher up, if, like, you can definitely notice, like, you're chilled out or anything like that. But with my dose, it does not have any effect on me other than calming my anxiety, which is amazing. Okay, on to more random things. I've been obsessed with plants this summer. I actually got this. This is a snake plant, or a mother-in-law's tongue, recently from IKEA. If you have an IKEA near you and you want plants, like, that is the place to go. They have so many plants. I got this for like $7. I got a fiddly fig, which I'll insert a clip here, for $20, which those are normally so expensive. And yeah, so I've just really been into plants. If you guys want to like more about that, I can let you know and going along with that. Sorry if like the angle's different and stuff, my camera died on me. But so Hawaii Five-O, I've been obsessed with all summer long. Yeah, I've also been loving Live PD. I'm actually currently watching it in my room right now as I was getting ready. And I don't know, it's such like a weird show, but if you like cop stuff, it's fun and entertaining to watch. I also love The Bachelorette. I'm so upset. I do not like Garrett. I wanted Blake to win so bad, but I really hope that Jason is the next Bachelor. I just think he was so sweet and like so genuine and I don't know. Anyways. And then World of Dance, I also really like. I'm not a huge, like, into, like, those kinds of shows. I used to watch American Idol all the time when I was younger. But I don't really like Dancing with the Stars or anything like that. But World of Dance is really, really cool to me. I don't know. I think because it's more of, like, a big production is why I like it better. I don't really know. So then, also, if you guys want, like, more TV show, like, a huge list of TV show recommendations that I have, I would love to give them to you because I love TV shows on Netflix and stuff like that. Also, leave any recommendations you have down below. I love crime shows. Those are like my top favorite. But I like all sorts of stuff. So those are all of my current summer favorites. I hope this video is not too long, but granted about the fact that my battery died, I have a feeling it'll be very long, so I'll try to shorten it up for you guys. But yeah, thank you so much for watching. Let me know down below what your summer favorites are, and make sure to follow me on Instagram and subscribe so you guys can see my next video. It's actually gonna be related to this top, so if you wanna see what this top is all about, then make sure to subscribe so you can see my next video. Thank you guys so much for watching, and I'll talk to you later. Bye.